It's getting to be my most favorite time of year. Game Master's here, and Halloween is just a month and a few weeks away, and I'm already prepping my campaign with some fun, horrific monsters for my players to encounter. We've been traversing Wild Space and the Astral Sea as of late, using information found in the new Spelljammer setting, and one of the creatures that I'm most certainly going to be using is the Nathalgu. These guys were born in the Far Realms and are large aberrations. Generally cruising through Wild Space, they look like massive spider crab things. Their body is large and round, similar to an Orb Weaver spider. If the spider's thorax and abdomen were kind of mushed together. The Nathalgu have four large eyes and six long segmented arms, legs, with two of them ending in crab-like pinchers. They have a mouth that is full of razor-sharp teeth. Now this is where all of those parts come together. Fair warning, this is kind of gruesome. They will drift through space hunting humanoids, and once they have felled their victim, they will cut open the victim's head and remove the brain and swallow it whole. Within the Nathalgu's head body, I mean the whole thing is kind of its head, are pockets. And it's within these pockets that the consumed brains will be stored. It then uses those brains as receptacles to enhance their own magical abilities. Now, this I'm adding a little twist to. Remind me in a moment and I'll let you in on that little secret. Before we jump into the Nathalgu stat block, I'd love to ask that if you're enjoying this video, to please give it a thumbs up. It helps to grow my channel by triggering that almighty YouTube algorithm, and you'll get thanks points from me. Thanks. The Nathalgu is typically chaotic neutral and has an armor class of 14, 10d10 plus 40 hit points, and has a strength of 15, dexterity of 8, constitution of 18, intelligence of 12, wisdom of 11, and charisma of 7. Has a challenge rating of 4. And you'll see too that it has under languages, deep speech, and something called brain dump. Brain dump works like this. When it consumes a brain, it gains the ability to speak and understand the language known by the brain's previous owner. And this is a little hint as to what my little twist is. Just be sure to remind me to tell you about that twist. The Nathalgu is also of unusual nature in that it does not require air. For actions, it has the following. It has multi-attack. It can make one bite attack and two claw attacks. It can exact brain. This is considered a melee weapon attack, and the target must be an incapacitated humanoid. The Nathalgu will deal 10d6 piercing damage, and if that causes the target to fall to 0 hit points, the target is killed as the Nathalgu has just extracted and consumed its brain. There is no save. This just happens. Another action it has is Mind Blast. It will emit psychic energy at a humanoid that it can see within 10 feet of itself. You gotta make a DC 14 wisdom save, else you take 2d8 psychic damage and are incapacitated until your next round. So its order would be logically this. I would do Mind Blast to incapacitate, then exact brain for the win. Finally, it has spell casting. It can cast one of the following for each brain it has consumed. Or rather, the spell is unlocked once a brain has been nested within one of its pockets in its its body. Guys, these are going to be so much fun to play with. Nathalgu can cast the following without need of spell components. If it's got one brain, it can cast Arms of Hadar. Two brains detect magic. Three brains gives it Magic Missile. Four brains and it gets Tensor's Floating Disc. Five brains and it can cast Darkness. Six, Hold Person. Seven gives the Nathalgu invisibility. Eight gains the spell Spider Climb. Nine, the spell Fear. 10 gets it Hypnotic Pattern. 11 brains is Major Image, and if it consumes 12 brains, it can cast Stinking Cloud. When these things are encountered, the DM rolls a d12, and that determines how many brains it already has within it. And this is where things can get kind of interesting. Once a Nathalgu has 12 brains in its pockets, it has an overwhelming urge to return to where it was born in the Far Realm. Now, why is that interesting? Well, when one of these is encountered, who knows how determined it is or what its determination is. Does it want to eat your brain or does it just want to go home? Oh, yes. Thank you for reminding me. Okay, here's my twist. As a dungeon master, I'm going to state that in my campaign, if the brain this thing consumes belongs to a spellcaster or belonged to a spellcaster, it will also be able to cast spells that that brain knew. I'm going to call this ability Exact Brain. Exact Brain works like this. When a Nathalgu consumes a brain, if the brain's previous owner was a spellcaster, in 1d4 rounds after consumption, it gains the ability to cast the spells that the brain knew. Now, I've been giving a lot of coverage to Spelljammer as of late, and if you'd like to see more, be sure to check out this massive playlist. With Halloween right around the corner, I've got a few more fun and horrific Dungeons & Dragons videos in mind for you guys, so be sure to subscribe. Let me know in the comments below, should I tweak Exact Brain or leave it as is? Until next our paths cross, how many times did I say Nthalgu in this video?